If you have already subscribed, then click the bell icon to get instant notifications when I put a new video up. Do it now. What's up guys, welcome to Mad Stuff with Rob. I am Rob and I'm back with another fun DIY video just for you guys. Now today's DIY is really interesting. Now I live in Mumbai and we don't get to see too many birds here. All we see is pigeons. Now I know it's a bird, but I don't like pigeons that much. I would like to see other birds, but unfortunately we don't see them. So I thought, why not do something that will get the outdoors indoors? Have the birds come into your house. That's right, we are making a bird mobile. Now I've done something similar earlier on my TV show. Have you seen it? No? Don't worry, because you can see it right here. And this one is even simpler and cooler. And this will not only act as a cool room decor piece, but will also add some cool, calming, soothing effect to your room. Just a bird gliding and flying all around. Get ready, it's time for some DIY. Why? Because I love it. Okay, let's make a bird mobile. So to make a bird mobile, first you need to make a bird, right? So I have a sheet here and I am going to draw a basic outline of a bird on this. So you can see I have done a basic outline of a bird here. So my seagull is ready. Now I am going to add the wings. If you have seen a bird mobile, the mobile is in different pieces. There is a body and the wings. They are separate pieces and then you need to attach them so that it moves freely. So we are making a 3D bird. So this is just the body and now I'm going to make the wings. There you go, the wing is also ready. And like I said, I am making a seagull. So I have made a nice big wing. And I'm going to use this as a template. And using this template, I'll trace the outline on mount board and cut two wings. So to cut it, I'm using an X-Acto knife. Now when you're using an X-Acto knife or a cutter or a blade, please be extra careful. Don't hurt yourself. There you go, a bird and the wing, you can see. Now it looks like a seagull. Okay, now I'm going to get the mount board in. I am going to trace the bird and the wing on this. There you have it. We have our first outline. Now I am going to flip it and make another one. Why I'm making two? Because I'm going to stick and sandwich these two together. Because we need more weight in the middle for the mobile to work. There you go. The outline of the bird is done. Now we'll make the outline of the wing. There you go. We have one wing and we'll do the same thing. Flip it and make another outline. So we have two wings. There you go. We are done. So now we need to cleanly cut these pieces, but we'll do that with the power of editing. There you go, our cutouts are ready. So now we'll get the wings out and we'll use these two pieces and we'll stick them together. All right, so the bird's body is ready, you can see here. And because of the two pieces, it has more weight, which is perfect. So this is done. Okay, now I'll show you how you can attach the wings to the body. Okay, so we start with the wings. So first we'll make some holes on the wings. To do that, I'm using a thumb pin. Now we're going to make two holes on the corner of the wing, like this. We will align both the wings, like that. Hold it in place, and then just make the marking for the hole, because we want the hole in the same spot. There you have it. And now we will make a hole here. Okay, so the wings are now ready. Now what we'll do is, we'll place the wings, get the body in, and with the pencil, we'll make a marking right in front of the hole that we just made on the wing. And we'll do the same thing on the other side. Now again, using a thumb pin, we'll make a hole. Now because this is thicker, it's slightly more challenging to make a hole in this. So you can take an eraser, place it on the eraser, and then just apply some force with the pin so that it goes through the eraser. This way it won't hurt you and you will be able to make a hole very easily. There you go. So now we have two holes on the bird's body and two on the wings. Look at that. All right, now we are going to take some nylon string and we are going to tie all these pieces together. So before I pass the string and tie all the pieces together, I'll show you how you need to lay down all your pieces. So here we have the body and the wings on either side. So we'll take one of the wings. So first we'll take the string and pass it through the bottom of the lower hole and then pass it through the top, take it out. Then take the string through the body's first hole, then take the string, then pass it through the bottom of the other wing, then go down to the lower hole, pass the string through the top like this, then move towards the body, pass it through the second hole like that so that you come back to the same spot to tie a knot. And now we have these two ends, but before we make a knot here, we will pull the strings a little bit. And you have to make sure that there's a slight gap between the two pieces. Don't make it too tight, otherwise the wings won't move freely. Then you can just cut the extra bit. Okay, so all the pieces have been tied together. And you can see already we have a slight balancing act happening here. But you need your hands free to understand where you need to tie the string on the wings so that the bird can hang freely and balance like this. So for that, I have a very simple technique. We will take two books like this. And now we'll place the bird on this. Join the wings together like that. And then just release it. And you can see it's balancing here. If I gently move it. Once you have that, then take a pencil and then just gently mark on the wings exactly where the book is lined up, because that's where you need to add the string to hang the bird. Now that we have the marking, let's get the books out. And now what we'll do is, these markings that we have, we are going to make a small slit. So I'm taking an X-Acto knife and right over the marking, I'm going to make a small slit. And we are done. Now we'll take the string again. And this time we need a long piece, almost a meter. So 1 meter for one wing. First take one string and take both the ends and tie a knot. What we are doing here is we are making a small loop, just like this. Now you can see we have a loop. I know it's a little difficult to see because this is a nylon string and it's almost transparent. And that's another reason why we are using it. Now we'll take this loop and pass the wing through it like this, and then just pass it through the slit. Do the same thing on the other side. Okay, let's lift our bird up. There you go, balancing pretty nicely. So now obviously I won't be holding it like this, so we need a nice long stick, and then we have to pass the stick through these loops, get the optimum distance, and then take your marking on it. And then you can attach a hook or tape it. Just finalize that position so that your bird just moves nicely in that spot. All right, so let's get a stick in. You need to figure out the optimum distance so that the bird hangs nice and straight and also flies properly. Look at that. So I think that distance works. Now, once your distance is final, you can take a marking. Just a rough marking like that, and then you can either tape it or you can add a small hook. Basically, you have to lock this in place. So as you can see, I have a marking on the stick, and now I am going to attach a small hook to this. All right, so we got two hooks right here, but they'll go on the bottom. So we need to attach two loops on the top so that we can hang this bird wherever we want. So I'm taking some more nylon string and passing it through these two hooks on the top. All right, so I have attached this loop to these hooks so that the stick can hang and you can hang your mobile anywhere. But before we attach the bird to these hooks, let's add some detailing to the bird. Okay, so the painting is done. So now let's hook it up. There you go, align it, and your bird mobile is ready. Check it out. All you need to do is just pull it a little, very gently, and it starts flying. Now you can hang this anywhere in your room and just enjoy. Play some soothing music, lie down, and watch your bird fly. I really like this technique of making a bird mobile, and I made a bird here, but if you don't want to stick to birds, you can make whatever you want. You can make a dragonfly, you can make a bat fly, you can make a human fly, I don't know, and try it out. It's a fun technique. So if you enjoyed watching this video, then please give it a big thumbs up, like, share, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, because we make a lot of cool and fun stuff here. And if you're trying this out, then please click pictures and share them with me. You know how to get in touch with me. I'm on Facebook, Snapchat, Instagram, and right here making DIY videos just for you guys. So I'll see you in my next video. Until then, do good and be good. Peace.